Hare Krishna.
What is our greatest treasure is often not what we treasure the greatest. There are many things which are vital for our existence, but we don't really value them that much. So for example, air, light, heat, these things, we absolutely need them. But because they're so easily available for us, so often we don't really value them. And similarly, if we consider our relationships, we may pursue goals and targets and ambitions so fervently that we may neglect our relationships. And later on, if we lose a loved one, that is the time when we realize, oh, what did I do? How did I go so much off balance? Along with this, we can also consider that what is our ultimate treasure? Our ultimate treasure is our spirituality, is our realization of our spiritual identity and our relationship with the eternal spiritual, supreme spiritual reality, Krishna. So, we are all souls, and we right now also have a relationship with Krishna. But we don't value it. We neglect him, we consider him unimportant. We consider him from a utilitarian perspective, that when I'm in trouble, I will ask him for some help. But as we grow spiritually, we start realizing that our relationship with Krishna is our greatest treasure. If we have that, we don't need anything else. And if we don't have that, then nothing else matters. So it's important, extremely important for us to connect properly with Krishna. And for that, what do we need? For us to value the treasure. So Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita, in the 6th chapter, about the spiritually realized seers, Yam labdhva chaparam labham manyate nadhikam tataha yasmin sthitona dukhena gurunapi vichalyate. So he says, Yam labdhva, having attained this, chaparam labham, that chaparam labham, that there is nothing greater to be attained. Manyate nadhikam tataha, one thinks like this. Now here the thinking is important. Here the thinking doesn't just, it doesn't mean subjectivity. It rather, thinking indicates the harmony of reality with objectivity. That is, that when we think in a particular way, we naturally act that way. So, if we think of something as valuable, then we treasure it. Now, by mistake sometimes, something which may be valueless also, we may overvalue it. But if something is valuable and we learn to value it, just like a child may not value a currency note, but an adult values a currency note. So like that, when something is intrinsically valuable and we also recognize it to be valuable, then we treasure it. So spiritual growth is essentially the alignment of what is our greatest treasure with what is our conception of our greatest treasure. In material consciousness, we treasure worldly things, material things more and more. But in spiritual consciousness, we treasure spiritual things more and more. And that is how we grow. That is how we ultimately attain Krishna and unite with him in a bond of eternal love. And even before that, in this world, if we are aligned with Krishna, we march forward steadily towards him. We can face life's reversals with dignity, with integrity, and ultimately attain him. Thank you. Hare Krishna.